The idea for this video will be to talk about product measures, the motivation, and set all the topics that we need to define and work with in the next couple videos. So why do we care about product measures? The motivation is actually pretty straightforward. We've been working with measures for quite a while now. Another question is, let's say I have two measure spaces, x with some sigma algebra px and a measure mu, and another one, y with a sigma algebra by and a measure nu. My question is, how can I define a measure on the product space? Basically, what we want is, if this is x with my measure mu, and I take the product with y with measure nu, what I want is that if I take just some set here, let's call it E, and some other set on y, let's call it F, and I take the product of these two sets, so I'm going to have what's called a rectangle, but of course these are abstract spaces, so this is just a picture. This is the set E times F. Well, I want to be able to measure this set. And we know that if we're working on the plane, then rectangles, the area of a rectangle is the product of the length of the bases times the length of the height. So let's say that my product measure, or some measure in this product space, is called lambda. Then if I want to measure lambda of E times F, well, I would expect this to be the measure of E. E is measure with measure mu, times the measure of F, and that is with nu as a measure. So measure of E times measure of F. This would make sense. But how can I define this measure lambda? So if I define this measure lambda like this, things get complicated when I take a set that is not a rectangle. I mean, let's say I have some set like this, then what's the measure lambda of this set? Well, this is no longer just a product of two sets, so things are just too complicated for us. And this is our motivation. We want to be able to define measures on products of measure spaces. A more particular and clear example of why we want this is, we know how to measure things on the line with Lebesgue measure, but we don't know how to measure things on the plane because we only learned about one-dimensional Lebesgue measure. And what happens then in the space or on Rn? Well, that will be our objective. So if I want to define a measure, what I need is a sigma algebra. So our first step could be to define a sigma algebra. And there are many constructions of product measures, and they're all equivalent. And we will be using some theorems that we haven't talked about in a really long time, such as Cacciatore's theorem. So the idea for the next couple videos will be to define this measure lambda. And this is how we are going to do it. We will start by defining an algebra on the product space. Let's call this algebra bx times by, and this time I'm going to put it with a square. So this is going to be an algebra. And then on algebras, well, we can't define measures, but we know we can define pre-measures. So the second step will be to define a pre-measure on this algebra. Let's call this pre-measure lambda. And now we know by Cacciatore's theorem that we can extend the lambda to a measure on the sigma algebra generated by this algebra. And now this extension of the pre-measure, we're going to call it mu times nu. And this is just notation, but this is only one measure. It's called the product measure on x times y. It's defined on this sigma algebra generated by the algebra. And the name that we're going to give to this sigma algebra, product sigma algebra, is bx times by. And this symbol times is going to be with a circle. So that's the usual notation for the product sigma algebra. This is the standard notation for the product measure. And it's not exactly the product of two measures. That doesn't make any sense. It's just one symbol to represent a new measure. Could have been lambda if we wanted to. And now this measure will satisfy the properties that we want. So if we take some set E, that's in the sigma algebra Px, and some set F, that's in the sigma algebra By, then two things happen. First of all, E times F is an element in the sigma algebra of the product. And second, what we wanted, that we said at the beginning, the product measure of E times F is the measure of E times the measure of F. And these are the two properties that we want product measures to have, just so that it makes sense to work with them. So we have to do all these things in the next few videos. And once we're done with this, we'll have a measure in the product space. And once we have that, we can learn to integrate with that measure.